You put your
My screen is visible?
Yes, your screen is not visualized.
Okay, I have not shared, I think. I'm sharing my screen.
Please.
Okay. Share.
Make it full screen.
Yeah.
I'll just introduce you and then you start.
Okay.
Yeah. Friends, it's my real great pleasure. You go to the CV slide. Please go up one slide up.
Okay. Bombay.
Please go one slide up, Dr. Chapman.
Just a bit. It is not moving.
You just click right click and previous.
Right click and
previous.
Not working. Yes.
Okay. He is a very established physician in New Delhi and the online senior consultant physician formerly at Fortis Hospital, Shalimar Bagh, and for at Suraj Support Super Specialty Hospital in New Delhi. The governing member of API 2020-2023, is the founder and past president of North Delhi Physicians Forum, and a past faculty member of Indian College of Physicians, that is Indian ICP, FICP. And I would like to mention here that there are a lot of physicians who are in this group and they should pursue their FICP to have additional qualification. He's a past chairman as well as secretary of API Delhi State Chapter, past treasurer and executive member of IMA. He has got several publications at national and international journals, and he is the member of editor board of advisory board of our prestigious Journal of Association of Physicians of India. His email and mobile number is given for any further interactions. I request Dr. Chabra to start his presentation. We welcome you and we are all eager to listen from you. Please.
Thank you, Dr. Kulkarni, for all the kind words. First of all, I would like to thank you, NMDF, for giving me the opportunity. And I am very kind to Dr. Kulkarni. He has chosen my name for this presentation. As you know, the violence has increasing day by day in the medical fraternity. So it is very, very bad. It becomes a disease-like. So first of all, this presentation is exclusive for the education and the motivational purpose. There is no conflict of interest or any intention to hurt anyone in person, fraternity, government, media, action, or the organization. In fact, it is an observational and the evidence-based presentation. So this presentation is based on many discussions with the office bearer for the various medical associations to which I am associated, esteemed IMA members, and group of the senior physicians who want to restore the harmony among us and to regain the lost dignity of the medical fraternity, especially of the doctors. So I have also discussion with the various departments and public too. So in effect, it is an outcome of the holistic approach, evidences and the observation. So first of all, I would like to dedicate this present to my father and preacher who taught me to unite the people, and none other than late Shri Jagdish Chandra Chhabra and late Dr. R.K. Mitruka, who taught me a lot of things, how to unite the people. They left heavenly abode. I miss them always. So violence against the doctor is become a disease, like, and it is a pandemic, like the COVID-19. So there is a steep rise in the violence against the doctor that made a stormy time for the healthcare system, like this. In the morning, you see in the newspaper or in the TV, so many violence in the hospitals and everywhere regarding the bill and all that. Parents detect the sign of the life. These are the stormy time for the medical fraternity. What to do? The violence was almost nil or the minimal in the day-to-day clinical practice. Then the profession was considered as a noble profession, when there was no political interference in the healthcare system and no businessman or the corporate involvement in the healthcare system, no consumer protection act at that time. It was, there were almost nil violence. The violence has increased in the day-to-day clinical practice. Just a minute. I will keep it like this.
Your slides are not moving, Dr. Chava.
Just a minute.
Make right click and next. Make it on the screen. Make a right click and next. Next.
Yes.
So
the violence has increased in the day-to-day practice, clinical practice, when the Google media made the various treatment option available with the advertisement or even on the online by, you know, by dash. So there is a lack of the modern techniques in the hospital and clinics, and disease are managed by the, most of the time, non-medical person. They are managing all the disease. I will tell you in the later part. Miscreants are against the modern medicine, but the people want the high-tech treatment. Digital media has made everyone treating doctor, especially in India. They have made the, everyone the treating doctor. So there is a model of the private public partnership model on the healthcare system that also disturb the healthcare system. So the real doctors are always a soft target for the public to the government, because every quack, when there is any disturbance in the patient, they will send the patient to the hospital or the corporate hospital. The patient will die in the hospital, then violence will occur definitely. The real doctors are always soft target for public to the government. So many violence, still we are morally bound to the duty and COVID warrior, so-called COVID warrior. See what a great picture which shows how a doctor is trying to save the life by not caring about his life. Salute to the painter who painted this picture from the heart. So if you see the mode, what happened to the...
No, right, go on, Nick.
What if you see the doctor modality in the first and second wave in the India? See Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Haryana, Rajasthan, more than 1500 doctors COVID martyr at Punjab. It is very bad news for the doctors, for the healthcare system. So bureaucrat and politician have made the doctors like this, the serenity of the doctor. They have made the doctor like this. Politicians are the same. The IS officers, the bureaucrats are the same. They made the profession like this. So we had requested the people to stay at the home for you. We stay at the workplace for you, and you stay at the home for you. But they are not listening at all. And that led to the second wave. Still, if the people are not serious, then ready for the third wave, and we are predicting for the third wave. So what we give to the patient and patient care? Safety to the patient. This is the safety given by the doctor. And this is the safety to the doctors given by the public. The very bad scenario of today. So violence are still on. It is a very, very recent violence, assault on a junior doctor on the 1st June 2021 in the Assam, Tejpur. This is a recent example of the violence. So if there is violence on the doctor, what will happen? To the violence, personally, there is a broken relationship. Alcohol and the substance used to the habitual of the doctor. All the doctors are depressed, and there may be a tendency of the silent to the doctor. Similarly, professionally, there is a decreased quality of the care and increase the medical error. If there is so many tension or the long duty hours, then definitely the doctor will be, cannot give the services properly. They decrease the patient satisfaction, they cannot satisfy the patient, or decrease productivity and the professional efforts by the doctor. So this is a scenario. If they assault the doctor, that will happen to the doctor. So the management of this disease, I will consider it as a disease like a COVID-19. we are a doctor, we can either diagnosis, investigation, treatment of the complication. I will take one by one. How to diagnose this violence against the doctor? One is the lack of the proper awareness of the disease and the high-tech treatment expectation by the public level. Another lack of the coordination among the government, medical fraternity, IMA, public and the doctor, and lack of the available resources and infrastructure, imbalance in the law and ethics, and media involvement, and the bill, especially in the private hospitals, and the over-expectation of the outcome of the treatment. These are the few things which can cause the violence. So I will take one by one. A lack of the proper awareness of the disease and the high-tech treatment expectation from the public. After last survey of the people, we have asked the people what they want, where they want the treatment of the patient, and the outcome of this survey, public at large desire only well-equipped and the high-tech hospital. They don't want the other hospital, only with them. Everyone expects the advance in the high-tech treatment, either free of the cost or the charitable labor, with the help of government, neta, or the trustee. These are the three things they want the treatment, like the charitable or the free of the cost. In fact, for the truth, what is the truth? It is not possible for them to deliver with the charitable or the free of the cost with the high cost of the treatment. So ultimately, that will lead to only one dialogue. Doctors lutere hai. Doctors are robbers. Only doctors are robbers. They don't say any to the corporate hospital or the private hospital. They say the doctor lutere hai. So if the people are fail to get the free of the treatment, because of the treatment, or the charitable treatment, or the healthcare service, what will be the consequences? They will assault the warriors, healthcare providers. In the anger, whosoever comes in the front, they will, and they take the kanun or the law in the hands. What will happen? This is a scenario of today, of the healthcare system. All the patient wants to, I think this is disturbing, I think, this bar. This is a patient and want to assure the doctor what is the need of the hour. Need of the hour, awareness about their wrong step. They are taking the wrong step. Aware them and ask them, think twice before the act. Take this step. If you assault your doctor or the healthcare provider, means you are assaulting yourself. This is a scenario. We have to aware them about this step. So, have you ever thought who is the sufferer of the violence? Only doctor, patient and their attendants are sufferers. And another I will add, if you want to tell them, are the law with the taxpayer. Who give the tax, they are also sufferers in this violence. If there is a loss of the property of the hospital, either the patient, the charges will be added to the patient bill and build up an extra load to the fellow patient and their attendant, or they will recover from the professional fees of us, that they are corporate hospital, they will cut our fees and there is extra burden on the doctor. If the government hospital, there is a loss of the property of the government hospital, they will levy the taxes on the taxpayer. So what are the causes? Other causes, lack of the coordination among the government, medical fraternity, IMA, public and the doctor. Why? What is going on? That is the management graph. You see, they are managing the COVID-19. How they are managing? The webinars are increasing like the corona cases, and doctor knowledge are gradually increasing, but they are unable to apply due to the dominancy of the non-medical. And everyone has gone, the earning of the everyone has gone down or almost nil, some. But bureaucrats or the officials are missing from this graph. Why? What is the reason? Because they are not accountable and that they are getting the full salary. There is no cut in the salary of the bureaucrat or the bureaucrat officials. They are not bothered about anything. So, but they are managing the show. They are managing the show and managing the COVID-19 management with the zero knowledge of the COVID-19. So dear friend, medical fraternity is helpless due to the dominancy of the non-medicals. This is the fund of the very bad. So another is the lack of the available resources and infrastructure. If you see, if there is lack of the bed or the oxygen, lack of the manpower or the ambulance services, as Dr. Kulkarni was talking about the ambulance services, they will beat the doctor. If there is no bed, they will beat the doctor. If there is no oxygen, they will beat the doctor. They will all things, anything lacking, they will beat the doctor. This is the main cause of the violence. All will lead to the violence against the doctor. So another is the imbalance between law and ethics, very, very important. Ethics, Hippocrates, Thyrex, if they see in the three idiot picture, the Karina Kapoor say, Hippocrates ne to hamari laga di hai. This is wrong. According to ethics and law, we are always confused whether we are wrong or the right. Ethical and the legal, both are the opposite things. So ethics is a set of the moral principle and the code of the behavior and the governor and individual action and the other individuals of the society. Law are the societal rules and the regulations that are obligated to observe. Law have governed the practice of medicine for over the 100 years. So the combination of the law and ethics, that is the National Medical Commission, or the medical, it was known as the Medical Council of India and State Medical Council, all. So there are number of the rules and regulations. See, there are almost 72 laws and regulations regarding the medical fraternity for the hospital, for the doctor, or the, any 72 rules and things. If there is a number of the rules and regulations, no, that will all bear the corruption or the creed of violence. Any either corruption or the create the violence. See, always sword hanging on the doctor in due to these rules. That role. How medical practitioner or the doctor can work under the regulation or the over regulation, plethora of the law and the regulation, 72 laws. It is difficult to follow it. So, dear friends, that will lead to either the Baburaj or the corruption. These are the two things that will destroy the healthcare system. So other side of the side effect of the ethics and law, see, always lead to the dilemma in making decision. We are confused always to be taking the decision. It result into, if the result is not favorable, then lead to the violence. See, if you are seeing a very beautiful, very interesting match, your wife comes, then you are confused whether you should talk to the wife or this is just like the dilemma of the decision. So, dear friend, the medical legal, medical ethics and law, what is the dilemma and the decision? Behavior decision, what should I do? And motivation, why should I do? So, the behavior, what should I do? And motivation, why should I do? And these are the situation necessitating a choice between the two equal, unusual, undesirable alternative, which we have to choose. So, dear friends, you see the situational. What to be the, how we can take the decision? You see, the mobile torch helps to save the team life during the procedure. It was the AIMS hospital. If there is any, there is an untoward happening, that will definitely lead to the violence, converted into the violence. This is the dilemma in the making the decision. So similarly, media involvement, if you see, do the media have any important role in the violence? Yes. Definitely, because they can make the picture with the two views. There is no accident, they make the with the picture, they make the accident. Actually, there is no accident. It depends on the media how they present it. Similarly, the Dr. Lapa Dosa ki saja, wakilon ke niyantran karne wale next dress, MHA Ministry of the Health Affairs rejects the Health Ministry draft of the legislature bill of the product of the very, very bad. They can't protect the doctor who are at risk always, but they rejected the bill. It is very bad for the doctor. So, dear friend, this is the whether doctor is at fault? No. Doctor is not at fault. They have given the article, but they have put the picture like this cervical cancer. Cervical cancer se bachne ke liye tikakaran kijiye. AIMS doctor has given the article, but they are unaware about the picture, what they have given by the media. The doctor is unaware about this thing. The doctor is not at fault, but the media is fault. Media has to consult the doctor. So, what is at the media? Who will take the action? How will take the action? We can stop it. Stop media and the movie makers from debate, discussion, making the movie on the controversial or the sensitive issue without any evidence. And making the mockery, our is the noble profession. Ask them, don't make the mockery of our profession. It's a noble profession. Making unreal fact to the real fact by the movies. So, dear friends, who will take the action? It is not a work. It is not work of the doctor. It is a National Medical Commission or the State Medical Council who will take the action in association with the medical association, because these are all the medical associations are the non-government association. They don't have the power, but they can take the help of the medical association. So NMC must take the legal action on the filmmaker and their director. They should be punished for instigating the public and creating the breach in the trust. That is very, very important for the treatment of the patient. If there is no trust, then you cannot treat the patient without breach of the trust. So among the government, medical fraternity and the public. So, and making the healthcare system weak. If they breach the trust between among the us, then definitely the healthcare system will become weak. This is very bad. So the other is a bill, especially in the private hospital. See, the Fortis Hospital Hospital mein maut ke baad itna bada parchi bill. See, share of the doctor's fee only thousands out of the lakhs bill. The bill was in the lakhs, but the doctor share only in the thousands. This is the scenario of the doctor fee. In spite of that, they say the doctors loot rahe hain. So similarly, over expectation of the outcome of the treatment. Everyone expect the 100% result of the treatment, irrespective of the disease, whether the cancer, TB or any disease. They want the 100% treatment. Doctor God mante hain. You know, it is the over expectation. It is the cause of the violence. If not meet, then leads to violence. So question, I will put the question to all. Accident somewhere else. How many we can tolerate the other mistakes? Accident somewhere else, patient expires in the hospital, doctors are beaten. Alcohol liver disease, patient expires in the hospital, doctors are beaten. Heart attack due to the uncontrolled diabetes, hypertension, patient expires in the hospital, doctors are beaten. Building collapse somewhere else, patient expires in the hospital, doctors are beaten. Oxygen beds are not available, patient expires in the hospital or in front of the hospital, doctors are beaten. And lack of the infrastructure, patient expires in the hospital, doctors are beaten. Quarrel among the public and injured, patient expires in the hospital, doctors are beaten. Why it's so? See, what is the scenario in the India? Few years back, there was a quarrel between the police and advocate in Delhi. So at that time, the lawyers demand the justice who meant for that. And police demand for the security which meant for that. I don't know what will happen. They have managed it, but in the doctor are suffering from the violence against the doctor disease since long and try to save themselves. Doctors apni jaan bachane ki koshish kar raha hai jo jaan bachata hai. Similarly, doctors try to save our own life which meant for that. So dear friend, no one is there or no one is ready to listen us what is going on us. Nobody protect us. It is very, very bad. So I will say sarkar koi bhi ho, chahe either BJP, Congress, AAP, if the king is Duryodhan, order to unwrap the sari. If king is Yudhishthir, then lost the gamble. Apni halat to Draupadi jaisi ho rahi hai doctors ki. Agar Duryodhan hua to hamare ko sari utar dega, kapde utar dega. Agar king Yudhishthir hua to hame dev mein haar diya jayega. So doctors are always so target. Who are the doctors at risk? Maximum in terms RMO, CMO, PG students. How long do we tolerate the violence against our younger generation? जब कोई यंगर डॉक्टर पिटता है हमारे दिल में दर्द होता है बीइंग ए सीनियर ऐसा लगता है हमारा बच्चा पिट रहा है हाउ लॉन्ग वी कैन टॉलरेट दिस थिंग सो टाइम टू एक्ट नाउ और नेवर यू शुड टेक द स्टेप टू सेव देम सो डियर फ्रेंड हाउ वी कैन सेव देम व्हाट डू यू वांट वायलेंस आइदर यू वांट द क्लैपिंग ड्रमिंग ऑफ थाली और द कैंडल लाइटिंग फ्लावर शोरी आई थिंक एवरीबॉडी विल सेज गिव द आंसर It is a big no. We don't want anything, but we want appeal to stop the violence against the doctor. But we must appeal to our honorable Prime Minister, say the stop the violence against the doctor in the Mann Ki Baat, because Mann Ki Baat is very, very popular show. If he says in the Mann Ki Baat, violence, stop violence against the doctor, that will be more effective. We can combinedly appeal to our honorable President to say, in the Mann Ki Baat. So we want the safety at working place with the zero violence. It is our demand. not the clapping, not the candle lighting, not the flower covering. He want only the working the zero violence. So dear friends, prevention of this, how we can prevent it? Updating the knowledge from every place, from the public to the government, we have to time to time enhance the coordination among us. But this is the scenario of the today. Everybody say, I don't want to listen anything. कृपया यह ज्ञान मत बांटिए, हम सब ज्ञानी हैं. बट सी वी मस्ट अपडेट अवर सेल्फ फ्रॉम एनी अवेलेबल रिसोर्सेज. जैसे 3D में कहता है कि ज्ञान कहीं से मिला उसको बटोर लीजिए. यू कैन गैदर द नॉलेज फ्रॉम एनी वेयर. सो डियर फ्रेंड, बट वी वॉन्ट ओनली वन बॉडी इज देयर और एक्चुअली द डॉक्टर बिग, दैट इज द इंडियन मेडिकल एसोसिएशन. इट इज अ बिग एंड पावरफुल एसोसिएशन ऑफ द डॉक्टर. Is morally bound and can resolve the problem and issue of the esteemed medical profession. This is the IMA, along with the support of the other medical association like the API, CSI, RSDI, ASI, FOCI, NFMSA. So many associations are there. These are non-government, governmental association. So though they are academical oriented association, but they are for its member welfare too. Definitely, they are well for the member too. So one, we must empower and strengthen the IMA to take the action and encourage them to take the action against them, because it is a big association. It is a parent branch of the, all the doctors. So the lack of the coordination of the other medical association with the IMA. So in Indian Medical Association and its branches, what happens? There are self-made doctors group or the lobbies being guided by the political parties' guidelines. Especially since the 90s era. Before 90s era, nobody was bothered. But in the 90s era, there were Congress, BJP, are motivated or the influence groups. So bring us on the road for the baseless and unplanned protest like the politicians that led to the unseen problem in the future. Other medical associations are involved only in the academic activities, merely asked or taken into the confidence by the IMA and its branches to resolve the member or the issue the problem. So elected members don't justify their role. Once they are elected, they don't justify their role in the medical association. And except the president, secretary, and treasurer, other office bearers are only for their names on the letterhead. They don't do anything, only name on the letterhead only. Even the president-elect rarely appears throughout the year. Particular year is called, that is, year called is the learning or the training year. It doesn't come into the that year. How he can learn how to handle the as a president-elect post? I don't know. This is the scenario of the today in every association. So what is the consequences? As part of the unplanned protest, what is the opening? There was a protest against the quacks. Result into we are living in Delhi. Formation of the DMC to eradicate the quacks, but they have not eradicated the quacks. They have started the registered law doctor every 5 years and formed the DMC. There was a Mahasangram protest against the CPA and other issues. And you know, after before few years, definitely there was failure. Only 5,000 person crimes. It was a total of 10,000. Result, dissolution of the MCIE and formation of the NMC. So they demand for the security and the working place. Result, rejection of the bill in the violence against the doctors. In spite of there being so many MPs in the parliament, they cannot get it passed. So the demand of the electricity and water charges and domesticated in Delhi, they have levied the biomedical waste charges or the solid waste charges. These are the extra charges to the doctors. Only doctors are charged. So the to acknowledge the name of the doctors, the government warrior list, who lost their lives during the fight against the COVID-19, result appeal from the IMA and DMA for the collection of funds for the members, for the finance help to the martyr families, instead of the pressuring the government. They don't pressurize the government to give the compensation to the martyr families. They don't care, but they appeal to the members to collect the money. So dear friends, there was an insult to the martyr warriors. Recently, you have seen the fellow doctors. That was very painful for us. So who led their life in the fighting against the COVID-19. They're painful for us. So dear friends, no doubt IMA are doing their job with the definitely they have cut the violence against the protest on the 18th June. They are definitely two stalwart, that was Jalale or the Lele. They are doing their work with the patience. They are definitely hard working to get the leave for the doctors. They are definitely working. They are pursuing the government for the central law to end the violence in the doctor. I talk to both the president and the secretary. So what is the solution? What is the treatment of this disease? See, there is a treatment of the COVID-19. Probably first time in the history of the mankind. What is the treatment? Divided we stand, united we fall. But reverse, in the case of the violence against the doctor disease, violence against the doctor disease pandemic, we require the unity. Reverse of this, the COVID pandemic. So what is the unity among the medical fraternity? I will tell you about the unity. What is the unity? Only ill-sustained and short unity. During election or at the time of the incidence of the violence, there is a unity. Individual core group or lobby compromise obligatory basis, or they create the distance among the doctor. If they are united like this. So dear friends, what is the real unity? What is the need of the hour? Combined efforts of the Indian Medical Association and all of the medical association, they should unite and combine, do the combined effort. And pressure on the government, centralize the government, central state, and the level best to resolve our day-to-day problems or the issues, and ask them, we are vote or the least bother about the any party politics. Indeed, we are concerned about the medical fraternity and forthcoming generation to whom we are answerable. We say, Jawaharlal ye nahi kiya, Indira Gandhi ne ye nahi kiya, usne ye nahi kiya. Our younger generation ask, Dr. Chhabra ne kya kiya, Dr. Kulkarni ne kya kiya. They will ask her, we are answerable to them. We are not answerable to each other, but we are answerable to our forthcoming generation. So dear friend, what is the solution, probable proposed solution? Selection or the election of the deserving leader on his or the her credential or the capabilities, not on the party or the favoritism or the bribe or the false promises or the manifesto, because we are the in the medical field, that is not there. We are not politicians. So dear friends, we must elect or the select if it is unopposed. That the person or the kind of leader should have the 3D personality, that is a dynamic, daring and the bold leader at IMA and all medical association to improve or uplift the lost dignity or the image of the medical fraternity, especially the doctors. So dear friends, IMA and all medical associations must do combined efforts to improve or the resolve the issue. So dear friends, treatment of the complication, if there is occurrence of the violence or the disease, what is the treatment of the complication? Proper security and the protection, and remove the pressure from the senior who are under the influence of the politician party. All the junior resident doctor, if they want the FIR, then the senior will pressurize them. Better chup kar dijiye, kuch dijiye, to rok dijiye. Pressure should be avoided. And FRI must be made against the miscreant or the violator. And awareness about the IPS and the punishment of the violence against the doctor is at least knowing to the dealing person. Even the police don't know what is the consequence of the punishment, who do the violence, they don't know. We have launched a poster to aware the people. This should be at every public places, or the every hospital, every police station, this should be there. They will definitely, they should be aware about the punishment, either of the hospital property loss or the any violence on the doctor. This should be known about them. They will fear about these things. And violence has made the healthcare system just like a broken brain and creates a lot of the problem to deliver the service with the available resources, because we are in the India, we have the limited resources. How we can, this is a broken bridge, how we can cross it like this, the broken bridge. If you are the power working with the team, or the power of the teamwork make the possible impossible to the possible. That can be because we have the limited resources of the in the India. So we can cross it like this. If the government, IMA doctors and the public, they combine first, then we can deliver the best and excellent service to the people at large, for which we are morally bound. So dear friend, what is the need of the hour? softening rules and the regulation with a special consideration in the field of the medicine practice, as it is evidence, experience and the situation basis, not the document basis. Because the, with the document basis, you have seen the court with the same document sometimes behind the bar, or with the same document as evidence, they are out of the bar. So it is evidence, experience, situational basis. So it should be, the rule should be shorter. And improve the infrastructure and service of the hospital. Appoint all the trained staff, reception to the casualties onwards, to the ward, with the updating and empower them time to time. Update them. And doctor unity and the teamwork without any criticism. And enhance the coordination and ability of the public at large about the diseases and their complication time to time, with zero violence against the doctor. This is very, very important point. There should not be any violence that will disturb all the things. So media must be out of the healthcare system for the betterment of the healthcare system. Either they should be removed if they want to come in the healthcare system, or work with the OT approach to help the healthcare providers to deliver the services like this. कुछ चैनल ये दिखाते रहते हैं हमेशा, हॉस्पिटल में चिताएं इतनी जल रही हैं, इतने पेशेंट मर गए हैं, इतने बेड नहीं है. टीचर द डू यू नो, एवरीबॉडी नोज दिस इज अ पेंडेमिक, एवरीबॉडी नो इट इज आउट ऑफ कंट्रोल, एवरीबॉडी नोज इट इज आउट ऑफ कंट्रोल, हेल्थ केयर सिस्टम इज कोलैप्स्ड, टोटली कोलैप्स्ड. बट वी कैन वर्क विद टुगेदर विद द अवेलेबल रिसोर्सेज. सो दे शुड रिपोर्ट लाइक दिस, ठीक हुए मरीज का इंटरव्यू लीजिए, ऑक्सीजन सिलेंडर कहाँ मिल रहे हैं, दे शुड बी टेल अबाउट द ऑक्सीजन सिलेंडर वेयर अवेलेबल, प्लाज्मा डोनर्स का डाटाबेस बनाइए, किस हॉस्पिटल में कितने बेड खाली ये बताइए चैनल पे, एम्बुलेंस सर्विस कहाँ मिल रही है, कहाँ तैयार है वो बताइए. लेकिन नहीं, आपको तो सनसनी दे पेड सर्विस, उन्होंने कैश करना है, एकदम से डर पर बिठाना है लोगों में. दैट विल द कॉज ऑफ द वायलेंस. द मीडिया इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू क्रिएट द वायलेंस. दे शुड गिव द पॉजिटिव थॉट्स एंड द एटीट्यूड. So dear friends, in our affinity, they give a very loose remarks like this. Dr. Lalji, jald Amir Patne ke ilaaj mein unnecessary surgery kar rahe hain. They are doing the unnecessary surgery. This is given by the high profile doctor. I will not hide the name of the doctor. It is very bad. That will definitely create the problem and leads to the violence. So dear friends, once you want to take a message, change your attitude. Teamwork with the available resources, especially in the COVID-19 pandemic. So to work with the holistic approach, not with the tubular vision, you should do the holistic approach. If you never had the tubular vision, if you do work with the tubular vision, you see a very beautiful picture. But if you see with the holistic approach or the vision, broad vision, then it is not beautiful picture. So beware, always beware of the tubular vision. And avoid to take the decision with the tubular vision. For any violence or the incidents occur, should take them with the cool mind so that we can get the fruitful results. So dear friends, the important effect of the life, a big difference between the money and the time. We always know about the money we have, but we never know how much time we have. Dear friends, let us always value the time. Similarly, in the disease, management of the disease of the violence against the doctor's disease, so we always know how about the resources and manpower we have, but we never know about the violence when it occurs. So dear friends, let us always value our safety and the dignity first. Then we will, as you listen in the airport, in the airplane, they tell you, sir, first of all apni mask lagaiye, apni oxygen kijiye, then you help the others. So safety first, safety for us, then for the others. So dear friends, enjoy all available resources which we have and make our present time beautiful, memorable and violence free with our own combined efforts. Not a single, but it should be a combined efforts. So dear friends, it is a humble request to you, don't wait for the Mr. India who will come and resolve your issues and the problem. So dear friends, resolve your problem issues, problem yourself or with the, your friends or the, your combined effort or with the other medical institution. Resolve your problem yourself. Nobody will come to help you. So dear friend, if anybody wants my presentation, then write me email on this email ID, then I will send the presentation for aware the people at large. It is very, very important to aware the people so that we can stop the violence like this. Thank you very much for all attending and the all my fellow panelists or the speakers. Thank you very much. Over to the organizer.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Dr. RM Chawla. This is really very nice and a very compact way explained about the situation and networking and staying united and working with all the organizations together is your important thing. So now we have got lot many people in the audience. Now it is very difficult for me to decide any priority, but I will start first with the person who came first. That is Dr. Dinkar Desai. Dr. Dinkar, can you unmute yourself? Dr. Dinkar Desai is a very old friend from Miraj Medical College and a very dynamic person who has organized a 11-hour CAB in Thane. Dinkar, please. And now I request everybody that you be to the point about your situation, because I have already explained you the run of the problems which are there. We have got Dr. Sushmita Bhatnagar, and then we have got our RMA president, Dr. Devendra Jadhav. So everybody will get a chance to speak about, but try to be more focused and more to the point. Dinkar, please.
Yeah, thank you. It was wonderful to listen to you, Dr. Chawla.
Yeah, thank you.
It was a very good presentation. I want that presentation for you have made so many good slides there.
Okay, we'll get it.
Yeah.
Thank you.
At the outset, I would like to enumerate the experiment we had done in Thane. This was the same problem everywhere faced, violence against doctors. So you made enumeration of association and you only stuck to IMA. So the problem lies there. Because if some attack occurs, hardly any IMA member come for the help of the other IMA member. So that kind of thing was also there in Thane. So the IMA group for erected for this purpose was not successful. That's what I read about it. And then I thought for going for a United Doctors Forum, and we labeled it as Janraksha. So for 7 years, Janraksha is active. Janraksha, that's a Marathi madhe, samasacha vigrah karayacha jhala, ta janapasun raksha, ani jananchi raksha. So for public, it is jananchi raksha. So what is jananchi raksha? Ki tumhi jar kayda hatamadhe ghevun rahile, you will suffer the 3 years rigorous imprisonment and heavy penalty and all that. Because that time, 2010, Doctors Protection Act was in place. Hardly it is used because many of the police officers are not knowing about this act, number one. Number two, the doctors who are involved in the assault, they are not insisting for the this particular section to be applied, this particular act to be applied for the grievance. So, and many of us are not aware what to go and ask for the police. So lack of all these things has materialized that in spite of there being an act in Maharashtra, I'm talking about Maharashtra. Now, the IMA is demanding for a central legislation is similar to 2010 with more stringent punishment things and more stringent penalties. Now, initially, any maramari occurs, there will be some minor sections and there will be bail. But 2010 Doctors Protection Act, it has got a facility as known as non-bailable. So these were the things, and we wanted public to make aware. Now look at me. What I'm saying, we want to make public aware that these are the acts which are very serious in their nature. And if you are going to suffer because of the emotional imbalance at the time of some morbidity or mortality, then you are going to be in soup. So for saving this, we are making this awareness program under the name of Jansaksha. That was a simple thing.
Yeah, Binkar, we'll come to you again. Because there are not many
hands. Just 2 minutes. Yeah. Just 2 minutes.
Okay.
So the other part of the story is we united all the doctors and we formed WhatsApp groups so that we can make aware of any apprehension which is going on immediately, and all the groups were known in seconds. So once this group was formed, when the first thing occurred, there were something around 25 to 50 doctors, and this number is always constant. And I must tell you, or rather the experience has suggested, that in last 7 years there is no incidence in Thane where Thane, a big hospital, was burned to ashes. That is the history of Thane. There is not a single thappad in Thane. There may be incidences of hearsay, but they are managed. They are managed by our groups of doctors which are going and visiting the place, and then the doctor has got confidence that he can explain the patient very positively instead of being under threat or under pressure. And the key for this success was keeping good relations with 5 P's. The first is politicians, second is police, third is press or media, fourth is public at large, and fifth is patient himself. We have managed this. For our every Janaksha program, now it will be on Doctor's Day. So 1st July, we are inviting all of you to attend the program. It is a felicitation of all these politicians, police officials who are coming there. So that interaction is so strong that whenever the incidence occurs, we need not, because the incidence occurs because of some politician itself. Now we are friend to them, so that incidence cannot occur. So all these possibilities we have ruled out, and we are successfully managing 7 consecutive years without any kind of violence. The idea is IMA, NIMA, all the local associations, they are under the flag of Janaraksha. So Janaraksha is an association of associations. So we have managed that, and we are sailing through properly.
Thank you, Dr. Dinkar. Now may I invite upon Dr. Sushmita Bhatnagar, president of AMC. Sushmita, can you unmute yourself? Please.
Sir, thank you for inviting me here again. I wanted to highlight some few points regarding violence against doctors. I always feel that we should have a bi-pronged approach. One is internal, one is external. The internal approach is to actually, meaning this is because this has come up because there has been conversation with the people outside the medical field, and the important people, the people who matter, the people whose voices are and whose thought processes, we need to understand as to why violence is occurring. Because only laws cannot prevent violence, because it's a very long drawn process. My personal take is to improve the doctor-patient relationship to the extent that violence on its own reduces. Nothing can be completely eliminated, but it has to reduce. There are many reasons for these things, many reasons for violence which is occurring in today's time. So if we look at our internal systems, the healthcare delivery systems are honestly not up to date. So if we have to improve our healthcare delivery systems, then a lot of effort is required. It cannot be only at the level of our personal efficiency, you know, the efficiency of the doctors who are working on a day-to-day basis. So the entire healthcare, so the other st- stakeholders of healthcare delivery systems have to be on one page. Hello.
Yes, please go ahead.
Right. So I think we should even look at inviting the other systems, the other players in the system, so that we can have a dialogue with them and thus provide a situation or a scenario where the incidences of violence are less. Now, this is internal analysis. Now, the external is those people who are first is doing the act of violence, and second is those who are directly or indirectly involved, like the police force, like the other patients in the hospital, the general population, basically. So when we talk of the external factors, then the general public has to be educated on one end, and on the other hand, they have to be controlled, in the sense like how Dr. Dinkar Desai has said about implementing stringent rules and regulations, the laws being changed, so that it causes a deterrent effect on them to not pursue. Now, for that deterrent effect to happen, the laws, first of all, will have to be more stringent than what they are, and then it will have to be implemented. Who will implement them? The police and the courtrooms. So all of these are a part of our ecosystem, which unless and until strengthened, and unless and until we have a dialogue with all of them, I'm not sure whether we can just improve the or reduce the incidences of violence only working on the patients.
Thank you. Thank you, Susmita. Now we have got with us Dr. Devendra Dada, who is the president of Raigad Medical Association, and Dr. Raju Gokhale is a very a senior person in AMC, and he has been representing AMC for last so many years. Dr. Devendra, will you like to say something, and will you like to help all the doctors who are the small hospital owners in Raigad district who are running these COVID centers, and they are facing so many problems?
Actually, regarding this topic, our topic is violence on doctors and COVID. I think it is related, but COVID management and COVID permissions and COVID protocols is, I think, almost a need of our, like what we were discussing. As there are norms and like license raj, and even for getting license, you have to pay a bribe. And once you pay a bribe, they demand hefty amount. And if not paid, sometimes they cancel or they bargain. And even if you get a license, there are so many hurdles. Like as mentioned by Dr. S. V. Kulkarni in his message in the morning, there are different charts, like 2,400 A, B, C cities, which is very difficult for ordinary or average general practitioner or single owner, nursing home owner. And that we have to address, or we have to do something as an association, maybe any association at local level, district level, or organization like IMA. And we have to work on it so that we will get some concession or some exemption from this strict law. Otherwise, what will happen? We will get COVID center, and next thing, if third waves unfortunately ensues, we will see the picture like doctors are getting arrested for violation of COVID norms. And it is very difficult, like to follow other laws. It is very difficult to follow these laws, or like what the cause of violence is mentioned in our today's presentation, hefty amount, and that will be the cause, maybe cause of violence in the future. Regarding violence, one point I wanted to highlight with my experience in our district, many times ego of doctors get hurt when somebody politician or some non-medical person gets irritated or angry or try to make a violence. I think we should learn more about mob psychology, and we should keep quiet in that situation. If you are alone, if you have your support, like what Dr. Dinkar said, association, that is well and good. Even the Raigad Medical Association is association of all Pathis. And I can proudly say Dr. Kulkarni, who is associated with Association of Physicians of India and Association of Physicians of Navi Mumbai. So we all are together. We have around more than 5,000 members on different Pathis. We are staying together since last almost 25 years. So our seniors and our well-wishers have maintained that, and I can proudly say since last many years, almost 7 or 8 years, we have not seen a major violence which we used to see in our district. One thing I want more, which was, I think it was there, but whenever we get suspicion of violence, it is like aura, what we get in migraine. There is aura, somebody is complaining, somebody goes abusing. But that is the one point where we should pick up the anticipate violence, and we should file a FIR. FIR is must. When a FIR is filed, though police are good with us or friendly with us, but we don't know about what the other person or what our patient or what their relatives can do. So better file a FIR whenever you see anything. Or anticipate little violence or little miscreants or little misdeed from any patient or his relative, you should file FIR, and that will also definitely will reduce violence.
Okay.
And thanks, Dr. Kulkarni, for organizing these hot topics, violence and COVID related.
Yeah. Devendra, thank you very much. Dr. Chavra, can you unmute yourself? And Sushmita also. Friends, if you recall, I have circulated this a few of the problems which we are facing in managing the COVID patients under the capped amount. And the capped amount is so insignificant that if I just tally the services which we are giving and the government which is allowing it to do everything within 2,400 rupees or something, it is not possible. And Dr. Chavra, the acts are different in different states. Do you have something similar in Delhi?
Yeah, definitely in Delhi, there is a cap in the charges because they have allotted to the 10,000 per day for the COVID patient. It is very difficult. As I told you, there is a PPP, private partnership. Mm-hmm. So you cannot give the best services with this amount. Because doctor is involved, all the facilities involved, but you cannot charge. But if you cannot charge, they will take in the cash. That will erupt the corruption. Definitely, they kept the things, but in the hospital, they take the separate cash in the cash. That is bad. That will lead to the violence. So capping should not be there. If you are eating food in the five-star hotel, then you have to pay. If you are in the other hospital, you have to, the type of service you are getting, you have to pay for that only.
Is there any way in which we can go ahead? It is not going against law, but in what way we can put forward our demands? Because Devendra, even in Raigad, there may be around 50 COVID hospitals.
Yes.
And they have... means it is impossible for anybody to give the services within that period. I have got a friend in Sindhudurg, Dr. Edgar. He said that he is sustaining almost 1,000 rupees per person as a loss while treating a COVID patient. And suppose if you, Dr. Rajiv, can you unmute yourself? Because Dr. Rajiv is a very senior physician from this area. He has been involved with API and Raigad Medical Association. He has got good experience with handling with all these top bureaucrats and politicians also. Raju, can you unmute? Or Sushmita or Dinkar, If we form a sort of a coalition of all the hospital owners, nursing home owners in Raigad, Navi Mumbai, and now Vikram is there, but Vikram doesn't have his own hospital. But in Mumbai also, there are a lot many smaller hospitals which are giving COVID care. So this 4,000, 5,000, 6,000 cap, we cannot do anything. Is there any way in which we can go together? Can you suggest us, or even anybody from the audience also can suggest? Dr. Dilip Kadam is there, Dr. Sanjay is there. We can collectively represent ourselves and talk to the government, not bureaucracy, but you have to talk directly either to the health minister or to the chief minister. Please, any views on your side?
I believe there was a High Court petition made regarding this cap of charges. AMC, if I'm not mistaken, was part of it. So can the AMC representative tell us more on this?
No, Sushmita, for capping of charges, no, I am not aware of any petition from AMC. I don't think it was AMC who had filed the petition.
Can you please send your email ID as well as the phone number?
The medical field only. Dr. Kulkarni?
Yes.
Why they are capping only in the medical field, only of medical entity? On the healthcare system, why capping only the healthcare system? They don't keep in any profession. They're not keeping either CA or all the things. They cannot cap. But on the for doctors only, they cap. They cap the fees. They cap all the things. Also, doctors are the sole target. Everywhere, doctor is being bitten, doctor is being capped by fees. How can we can survive? After a long period of the making a doctor, and even the private medical colleges, they are so costly. How you can survive after that?
I will answer to you, Dr. Chhabra.
Yeah.
Ideally, what you speak has truth. Architect, chartered accountant, or advocates, they do not have any kind of capping. That will certainly come to our mind because they are the similar professionals like us. And yes, we too cannot be capped. That is for sure, because right to profession is there under the Constitution. And that has given us a fundamental right. That is not a simple right. That is a fundamental right. And right to profession means definitely, if you are a good surgeon, then you can say the appendix cost at me for 1 lakh. And when the junior person will be charging 20,000, I'm just, for example, I'm talking, the figures I don't know because I'm a pathologist. So the difference of 20,000 to 1 lakh, that has to be there. That has to be there. If you want to join a Supreme Court advocate for your legal matter, his charges will be definitely higher than a local district level advocate. That is simple, as it very simple to follow. A person who is reputed and renowned in Mumbai for some particular surgery or particular treatment, he has to take his experience in charges. There will be no doubt about it, and there is no bar. Now, what is the real problem in COVID times? We have got epidemic law in action. And under the epidemic law, the government has got all the powers to restrict your freedom. So with this, initially, government was not getting anybody, any doctor upfront. Even the other pathies doctors were also not in a position to open the doors. And all the doctors had shut the clinics and hospitals and everything. So nobody was there in the first few days of COVID. Later, the government and the officials of government, they started tapping us. Now, I will explain in Thane. I was the president of IMA. Then I was called by politicians. I was called by the commissioner. And then they wanted something from the private sector, because that time the public sector was not geared up. So I gave them the assistance. I don't want to give the list of what I had done. Point of interest for the debate is, there was not a single hospital except Horizon which was ready to work as a private hospital for COVID. Even Jupiter Hospital, Bethany Hospital, and Jito Hospital, which were leading hospitals, they were also not. So they made some compulsion to Kaushalya and some 3-4 hospitals. So they picked up four hospitals to start with. So as a president, my responsibility was to call people and to ask them to start the COVID facility at their hospital. So after 1 or 2 months, slowly, then people started coming to me. I convinced some 3 to 4. And once they saw that the original practice is down to zero, absolutely nobody is coming, and COVID hospitals are running full, people started coming to me. Yes, Dinkar, I want to get my hospital recognized as COVID hospital. So I went there. Now there are some 27, 28 private hospitals. Apart from 1,000-bedded COVID hospital, which was started in Thane, I was the coordinator. Shinde Saab asked me to go and work there as coordinator and to help there with the doctors and all there. So that also I have done. Point here is, in Thane, Dr. Sriram Kulkarni, I am running I'm the group admin of all the hospitals which I have started. So I have given this message of this particular topic to them. So capping is the real subject of today's meeting. So I do not find anybody has turned here because they are happy. After the first wave of COVID was over, TMC asked the hospitals to stop the COVID activity. It is not the doctors, they gave the surrender. Hardly 1 or 2 because of some problems. But TMC asked them to stop the activity. And when the second wave came, again these doctors came and we gave them the COVID stamp. So people are happy, they are earning.
Dr. Zakai, I agree with you.
The problem with you will be different because you are in a small place. But Navi Mumbai is kaha small place. Navi Mumbai is similar to Thane. I don't understand. My best knowledge is people are earning. And they only have earned, and RT-PCR people have earned. Rest of the medical fraternity has gone to docs. My statement.
I got only one question to both Dr. Chhabra as well as Dr. Dinkar. I'm just showing you a screen of the charges which are this into total of 2,400 rupees. Consultation, monitoring, bed charges, intensivist charges, oxygen charges, procedure like UT, urinary catheterization, rise tube insertion. I'm just stopping my video because the connection is weak. Then in the lab, you are a pathologist, you know how much this lab test costs. Urine culture, creatinine, CBC. Then again, nursing charges on this side, triple H, HIV, HBsAg, anti-HCV, ECG on the clinical side, X-ray, USG, 2D echo. How a general small hospital without oxygen can manage at 2,400 rupees? Then if you add oxygen bed, just 1,100 rupees. And if you just add a ventilator, 900 rupees extra. This is ridiculous. This is means it is absolutely not possible for, and there will be a deficiency of services very significantly. So please ask even Devendra and Rajesh are there from Raigad. I'm not talking only of Navi Mumbai. And Dr. Chhabra, what is the situation of the corporate hospitals in Delhi?
Yeah, similar.
Corporate hospitals are charging in their own way and people are paying because it is through insurance.
In the Delhi, they are charging another way. But I agree with the Dr. Desai, capping must be there in the pandemic, no doubt. But in the pandemic, other charges of the hospital should be reduced, like the electric charges and other water charges. All the charges should be reduced. They are not reducing their charges only. Number two, if you are making your hospital COVID hospital, suppose your hospital is a 100-bed hospital. In the COVID hospital, you have to make it the 50-bed hospital because there is a change in the renovation in the hospital. That is also give the extra charges to your hospital to compensate the charges. You have to reduce the other charges like the taxes, other charges, license charges. All the charges should be reduced. It should be balanced. Not only the capping is the thing. Capping is the road answer only. But other charges should be reduced equally, in my opinion. So, Dr. Kulkarni, am I right?
Sushmita? Yes.
What I wanted to say is that these charges are definitely, definitely ridiculous, as you mentioned. These are just so low that it is not possible for any hospital to actually take care of the patient with these charges. Now, because I have been in conversation with many other people, including those who are actually the providers, they have a feeling that they themselves, the government per se, they themselves are doing so much of expenses for this COVID, this pandemic. What they expect, what the government expects. Please don't take me wrong. I'm just trying to kind of have a balanced approach. And we also then accordingly modify our approach to the government so that we can have something which is much better than what it is now. So what I was trying to say is that when the government themselves is spending so much for the people in this pandemic, like, for example, they just take the vaccination. The vaccinations at centers are organized free of cost to everyone now. It's different that, you know, the private sector also has been playing a big role in this earlier. And now only 25% of the private sector is involved. But the government is providing free vaccinations for COVID to everyone, which is coming at a huge expense to the government. So when they are themselves giving to the people, they expect the doctors also to give to the people free of cost. So if that is the case, then we need to approach them accordingly and say that and ask them, do you really want us to incur all the losses which are not going to be reimbursed at any point of time, even in the future? Or are we supposed to pay from our pockets and treat the people? Government can afford that. But individual small nursing homes cannot afford that. Because the governments do have a lot of savings, or there are a lot of transactions in many forms. So they can easily manage this. But small sectors cannot manage. If they have losses for a period of 1 year, 2 years, they will never be able to recover those losses. So the government needs to be approached. There is no doubt about it, according to me. And they have to be told the story, which is the real the story on the ground level. The practical points that we have been facing, or the smaller nursing homes have been facing. So I think we should collectively approach the government.
Dinkar, I got a request for you that you talk to all your hospitals and just ask them that what are the standard charges which they apply in split weight of the patient. And Devendra, we also have to do the same thing. We have to make a Google form. And in that Google form, we will make around 5 to 10 headings of whatever the charges are going to there. We'll just compare it with. And for smaller places, I got a hospital in a place called Khopoli, which is a very small place. Rajesh stays in Polatpur. And there are many people who are not at all in a position to run the COVID center. Dr. Auti is there with us from Khargar. He said that he wants to surrender the COVID status of the hospital. But unfortunately, the other situation is that there are no other patients other than COVID status. So we have to pay our staff, we have to maintain. And Dinkar, what you said, that we are sacrificing, but the biomedical waste, they are charging us double.
Biomedical waste charges are exorbitant, and the government is not going to give you electricity free or anything. They don't want private hospitals to flourish. That is basically only they will help some of the corporate hospitals. They are not interested in our hospitals. First, that you take it in the right spirit. The problem is, you have shown the chart. I have not studied in detail. I can understand.
I will send you the things.
No, initially, what I remember that the charges were in Thane, the charges were 4,000, 7,000, and 10,000.
9,000.
These were the first slabs. I don't know now if they have reduced still more, but that was the thing. And why people survived and why people accepted and why people continued and why people are not interested to get delinked with the COVID facility is volume. You never had a hospital full volume. In Thane, there were so many hospitals who were about on the verge of bankruptcy.
Closure.
And there were huge loans. So the hospital which was under a threat of 3 to 4 crores loan default, that has cleared the loan and purchased another hospital in COVID time. So how can I say ki I will agree?
No, that is the
because of
situation
volume.
Is,
because of volume. If you have got a 10-bedded hospital or a 5-bedded hospital, then it is a problem. I can understand.
It is a big problem. So yeah. Devendra, if you analyze the hospitals in the Raigarh district, Sushmita won't imagine there are all the average hospitals are between maximum 10 to 20, 25 bedded hospitals. And anything bigger than 25, 50 bedded, you need a lot of manpower to operate and everything. Then you have to have your PROs and all the other systems which go on. So the smaller hospitals are going to die if this kind of situation comes. And these are the people who are like me, who are giving services for years together. I started my hospital in 1983. It's 37 years. Must have seen almost 10 lakh patients. But because of this rule and this attitude of the bureaucrats and administrators and politicians, if these charges are kept, somebody, we have to go to somebody and to talk to them. And organizationally, the only thing, only IMA and AMC can do it. Because in unfortunately, all other organizations are quite you know, placid. They don't have that kind of guts to raise a voice. So
Particularly in Delhi, the hospitals are happy to admit the patient who is having the mediclaim, because from through the mediclaim they get the more than the cash. They are not admitting the patient to the cash patient. Because in the cash, they have to cap the rates. In the medical patient, they take from the TPA. That is more than the cash patient in Delhi.
I will tell you what is the effect of capping. RT-PCR was sellable at 4,500 in the first run. And now it is capped to 800. Hello.
Yes,
it is capped to 800. And the antigen test, which was available at 600, it is now capped to 250. First of all, my pathologist people were interested in getting the antigen test for in their laboratory because everybody is not having that PCR machine. So I said, fine, okay, you go ahead. In due course of time, the prices came down. And now my people are worried कि जो किट्स लिए हैं वो कैसे कैसे काम करने गए. ऑलमोस्ट एवरीवेयर हैव यू सीन एनी पैथोलॉजिस्ट डूइंग एंटीजन टेस्टिंग? नो, नोबडी विल डू, बिकॉज एट 250 रुपीज खायचं काय आणि मिळवायचं काय असा प्रश्न आहे त्याच्या मनात.
ओके,
कुलकर्णी
सुबोध.
हॅलो.
यस, बोल.
Dr. Kulkarni, there were two private hospitals, I think, in and around Pune made that petition. Actually, if you may be aware that the government had made this notification of capping, and then there was a mandatory auditing of these bills. And based on this, they were asked to make refunds. And since the refund was not made for certain reasons, their licenses were suspended for non-refund of that amount. And these two hospitals had gone to the High Court and there was a interim relief. I don't know what happened finally, but I believe all associations, as you mentioned, IMA and AMC has more, the resources and the experience in going for litigation for such public-spirited activities. They should go ahead with this. First, we can make a representation to the government and then file a writ petition if there is no response. A lot of such doctors and hospitals had approached me and I'd helped them draft a letter against the, the decision of the audit. And I had even, after two responses, they didn't get any further harassment from the audit committee at least. And I had advised them through their local associations or larger associations to have a writ petition. But somehow nobody is carrying that forward.
Subodh, where exactly you are practicing? Subodh, where you are practicing? I know one Dr. Parmar who got this interim relief. Sushmita, can we take ahead with this and at least Devendra, yes. You be in touch with Dr. Raju Gokhale because he was very active in AMC for the hospital's organization and getting the thing. At least let us initiate the process. Even if 100 hospitals give their rates of the items which the government has given, and if it is something to the tune of 10% or 20% of what they have actually comes to it, means if they are 4,500 and our charges come to around 12,000 or 13,000, there is no point in working at such a low cost for the patients. Inkar, you also make a survey. I will try to send you a Google form. Mm. It is a very simple Google form.
Yes.
In which people have to give and then at
that
the end...
That is a very good idea that we will circulate the Google form and we'll get a feedback.
I share the screen again and then just tell you, we are all done this previously also. In smaller places, it is 2,400. Into that, you have to get all the consultations, nursing charges, procedure charges, lab charges, and even the radiology charges like USG, X-ray, and 2D echo. It is just absolutely ridiculous. It is so.
No. 24 hours. Paradigma dekho.
Yeah.
Paradigma dekho.
See, this is the
24 hours. Just a preliminary.
No, this is non-oxygen bed.
Huh.
Oxygen bed is 4,500 for the mid place, mid size like district places, Nashik and other. And these charges are for the smaller places, 2,400, 4,500, and 4,000.
So instead of 3,000, it is 2,400.
Yes.
Instead of 5,500, it is 4,500.
Yeah.
It is like that.
Yeah. And see, the charges for ventilator are only 1,100 rupees per day. It is means the person who had done it, I think they have not seen a patient years together and they are not gone to a hospital or they are not paid any hospital bill. And we are just taking it lying down and just we are listening to the arbitrators and the people who sit next to your table and ye bill kiska, ye kyu lagaya, wo kyu lagaya, ye cut kar do, wo cut kar do.
They get free treatment.
And the patient's relative, they instigate this thing like fire to others. Arey, mera bill itna tha, wo kam ho gaya. Aap bhi jao, aapko bhi milega concession. So this is at least it is good thing that we have got people like Dr. Arim Chavra, Dr. Desai, Dr. Sushmita, Devendra, who have given their views. Rajesh, tu pan bolala harkat nahi. The other people. Subodh, where exactly you are? You are in which place?
Uske saamne Sirur likha hai.
I'm a skin specialist and I'm also a medico-legal consultant. I'm based in Tardeo, Mumbai.
Tardeo, fantastic. Yeah. You shared me your email and the things. Then our means... so much of underutilization at such a throwaway price डॉक्टर दिलीप कदम इज देअर विथ अस, ही इज अ प्रोफेसर ऑफ मेडिसिन. डॉक्टर दिलीप कदम, तुमची आयडिया काय होती जरा आमच्या ग्रुपला सांगा ना सगळे. कॅन यू जस्ट प्लीज एक्सप्लेन मी युअर आयडियाज.
थिंग इज दॅट वेन यू कॉल्ड,
थोडासा आवाज मोठा पाहिजे.
हा नाही, आपला फोन झाला त्यावेळेला मी तुमच्याशी बोललो. आय एम ऑल्सो चेअरमन.
थोडा आवाज अजून मोठा पाहिजे सर.
आय एम ऑल्सो चेअरमन कोरोना टास्क फोर्स फॉर पुणे. द थिंग इज दॅट वेन वी से दी चार्जेस आर इनसफिशियंट, वी हॅव टू से व्हॉट चार्जेस आर सफिशियंट.
So okay.
The idea which I had proposed is that you they contact Institute of Chartered Accountants, ask them to evaluate the service charges. So there is any medico in that. Apart from doctor's charges, let them evaluate what is the actual expenditure which is involved for
not audible.
All the things what we do for the patient. So that will give you the exact expenses. Okay, on top of that, you can have your doctor's charges, medical charges, and that will then we will be in a position to put across the government that these are our actual expenses and you are paying us so much, so that they cannot cover even the actual expenses. So we cannot say ki the 2D echo cost 2400. So that is our with professional charges. What is the actual cost involved? We have to put it. You can add the space charges, electricity charges, all other charges into it, the maintenance charges, the payment of all others except doctor, and come to a conclusion ki what is the actual the expenses which are involved in management of such a patient. And then because after talking to you, I had a talk with government official. He also said ki you give none of the medical association or none of the doctor has given us the estimate that for the treating patient off oxygen, on ventilator, these are my bare minimum expenses which I have to manage for. So the thing is that as a doctor, we just talk, but we don't put on paper to the government is what are our expenses and how much are our reasonable charges considering Epidemic Act. Okay, so what the exercise which we have to do is to find out what is the expenses which are involved. Leave aside your profit and other things from every investigation and every management. So first and foremost, our government find the expenses and let it be certified by chartered accountant, so it is not biased by a medico. Okay, and then that particular thing we can submit to the government, and these are my bare minimum charges. On top of it, my medical coverage fee is so much, and then we can plead with the government that these are our rational charges considering the epidemic status. Okay, that is the one thing regarding charges, and unless we do that, government is not going to listen to us saying that the 2D echo is 2500, ECG is 500. You and me also know ECG paper 1 foot cost hardly 10 rupees, but we are charging 500. So that doesn't become my expenses. So what we have to find out is the sit down and have the exact expenses which are involved in it, and then talk about medical additional charges. Then only it will be logical to put forth to the government. That is one thing regarding the charges. The second thing about violence against doctors, right now there is a writ petition going on by Dr. Rajiv Joshi, pediatrician from Pune. He has put in a writ petition for violence against doctors. He has collected laws of 17 states. The maximum provisions are with, I think, Assam or Manipur, where there are 48 provisions, while Maharashtra law has only 8 provisions. So he has collected the important points from all the laws of all the states, because each state has different law. And he has formulated a model law for the violence against doctor, and the hearing on that is being presently heard in the High Court. The API Pune branch has also become a co-applicant with Rajiv Joshi. Similarly, many other associations from Pune have contributed to the expenses and become a co-applicant. So if all the association all over the Maharashtra become co-applicant, because whatever law he has drafted, even mental harassment is also taken care of. So if you people in the Mumbai and Navi Mumbai are really serious, you contact Dr. Rajesh, you can get his contact number from Dr. Mukund Penurkar and talk to him, get the law, whatever he has prepared according to the instruction by Honorable Justice High Court. And that is being considered and a committee has been appointed to study the law which has been formed by them and to find out whether whatever things they have spelled out can be practicable or not. So if all the associations in Mumbai, Navi Mumbai and all over Maharashtra are serious about violence against doctor, we should all unite and support Dr. Rajiv Joshi in his endeavor. And definitely we will get a better solution out of it. There are a few of my personal observations which are totally against or opposite to what we talk about. As far as violence against doctors are concerned, mainly it is a pure communication skills in the doctors and their juniors. Secondly, talking roughly and rudely to the junior doctors in presence of relatives is the major concern about violence against doctor in whatever the cases I have investigated as an inquiry committee member. So I think we should introspect why this is happening. So 80% fault lies on our side, 20% fault lies on the relative side. So that was my observation from more than, I think I must have been an inquiry committee member against violence against Dr. Pukmoy in more than 20-25 incidences. So that was my impression on that. So we have to introspect ourselves regarding that also. So those are few of my suggestions .
Yeah, thank you. But Dr. Kadam, how and when which chartered accountants will take this responsibility of evaluating the cost of a medical...
Basically, what we have to appoint a committee of chartered accountants to association and ask them to find out what are the real expenses which we have to incur for treating such patients.
And actually, in that capping charges, there are four things. One is blood products, second is IV fluids, and third is medicines.
Now you know, I also know, the IV fluid charges written on the bottle are somewhere around 70 rupees. But we get it at 14 rupees. We get it at a 14 rupees. Okay. But they will take it, those charges, MRP charges. And unless we give evidence, government is not going to listen to us. So this is the evidence, and this particular committee is an impartial committee by chartered accountants, and no doctor is a part of it. Because if doctor becomes a part, they feel that they are doing it for their own purpose, their own benefit. So we have to have an independent committee. I have talked this to our API members also, to our IMA also. But somehow there is a lethargy on our part to go ahead with such. I had a talk with all the administrators, all IS officers in Pune also. So they also say, you come with the proposal, you give us the figure, which is what are your real expenses. We are willing to revise the charges. But what we are just talking in the air. Yeah, I have so much of expenses, I have so much of expenses. Nothing on paper. What can they do?
So may I please add one or two points to my mind. What Dr. Dilip Kadam sir has said, I was actually just going to say that we need to have our own minimum charges list prepared. Matlab break even. It's for breaking even. Now in that break even analysis, we are not supposed to be including our investments, meaning the cost by which or through which we have our own hospitals. Right. So the investments have to be, meaning whatever we have spent to get all the machines, equipment and all that is not to be taken into account. So the capital expenses are not to be taken on a day-to-day basis. What all expenses are made?
It is to be taken into account. That's what chartered accountants do. They will measure your space. then the floor space, and we'll add the charges for that also, even including capital investment. And then as they see, if you have say 100 square foot area, 100 for 100 square foot area in the market rate, in Mumbai, if it is so, 50 rupees per square foot is the rental appreciation. So that
right. So, sir, that will vary from one area to another. From
yes,
one
and that's why
another.
That's why
it's not going
groups.
To be consistent.
No, that's why there are
the real matter of yes, Dr. Kadam, I agree with you. The real problem of the capping is government only takes into consideration the charges. For example, for a test, required charges. किटची कॉस्ट किती एवढी त्याला डिवाइडेड बाय किती टेस्ट होतात एवढ्या म्हणजे तुम्ही एवढ्या मध्ये तर तुम्ही त्याच्यावरती हा नॉमिनल तुम्ही 20% प्रॉफिट घेऊन तुम्ही त्याचं काम करा बट हु इज गोइंग टू बेअर द कॉस्ट ऑफ पीसीआर मशीन हु इज गोइंग टू बेअर द कॉस्ट ऑफ प्लेस द स्टाफ दॅट थिंग दे आर नॉट इन्क्लुडिंग दॅट इज द रिअल प्रॉब्लेम
Nee, they are not including, but we will make them to include if
yes.
we have
yes.
the chartered accountant sitting over there and adding up all the charges.
So Sushmita madam, the point sir, you will have yes. to add is the investment charges also you will have to add.
Right. So and one more point yes. is this chartered accountants will once they are appointed, even they are going to charge some fees. They are not going to do free of cost. This whole exercise.
Right. It will not be free of cost. That's why association should bear that particular fee for the interest of all the members.
So what would be the fees? That also we will need to know to take a call on whether association can
yes,
bear this
yes,
fees or
yeah,
not.
Yeah, so
that also is a
basically yeah. basically I had requested government
nee, madam.
To have
for that purpose chartered accountants. Chartered accountants are not that required. You can also make out the cost. Those who are running the hospitals, then for example, you can ask the cost of Dr. Sina. You can ask Dilip Kadam sir, and so many. And then you include in your Google this thing.
Dinkar, let Dr. Dilip Kadam finish.
If it comes through an independent agency rather than by doctors, it will be more preferable to put across the government rather than we ourselves calculating the costing, putting it forward.
But to the chartered accountant, we'll have to feed like that. If you want
yes,
to answer.
Yeah, it is cumbersome and it is going to be very time consuming also. To first identify.
The thing is that whatever least government has given in that particular chart. So there
yes.
is the investigation to be done free of cost. So we all know what are the cost, the real cost of the kit and how much is per test cost, and that per test cost you can feed, you can add the payment of the technician and other things who are there, the payment of nurses and everything, then the ventilator charges and disposable charges plus oxygen charges, all that. See,
sir, those are the fixed expenses. My suggestion was remove the capital expenses from this total that we are going to do. Take only the fixed expenses and the non-fixed expenses. And then if capital expenses are also to be added, then obviously the expenses are going to be rising. The institute or the nursing home or the center is going to exist anyway. This COVID will go at some point of time.
Yeah.
We are helping the government at this point. And so capital expenses, if we don't calculate or don't add in this, it will be much better. We just take our fixed and non-fixed expenses. That will minimize and then present it to government. I think it should be each and every nursing home or a hospital should do it themselves only, instead of association going through the whole process. First, it will invite tenders, it will invite applications from different members. It's a very long drawn process through an association if it has to be done. So my suggestion is these two points. So if we can, if everybody is agreeable on this, then we can definitely move ahead on this point.
Thank you, Dr. Sushmita Dinkar, Dr. Kadam sir, you have really given us a very valid input. And what I will do is I will prepare one A4 size draft. and say another 15-20 services which are included into this, and at least let us get an idea that which are the people who are likely to help us, because we have either somebody in the family or friend circle who is either is something called as an evaluator or a chartered accountant, these are the people who evaluate the cost of the things. So we'll go with that. And thank you, Dr. Chabra, Dr. Sushmita, Dinkar, Dilip Kadam, and all the Vikram. Vikram has been really very beneficial and very useful. Useful in getting all the things. Yeah, Vikram.
Vikram has connected me to you today.
Yeah. And yeah. Yes, job. Dr. Kamar, Ujwala, and this is we are recorded.
Ujwala is there. I cannot see her. Ujwala, are you there?
Yes, Ujwala Vardapurkar is there.
And Praveen was there from Kolhapur.
No. Dr. Snehal.
PP Patil? Pramila P. Patil? No.
I cannot, but they are just Dr. Neeta Biyani has just logged in right now.
Dr. Neeta Biyani is from Dhule.
Yeah.
She's there?
No, she's.
Dr. Neeta is there.
Dr. Kulkarni, I had one more point to make. Can I speak?
Please.
About the PIL that Dr. Rajiv Joshi, I wanted to inform that AMC is an intervener in that PIL of violence against healthcare. Now, there are two aspects that we are looking at. I am also part of that committee. At the moment, I am as an invited guest, but we have put an intervention plea to the High Court. The hearings have been happening in the High Court for us to be part of the committee. So in that, there are two things that we are looking at. One is the immediate measures, the interim measures, and one is the amendment of the Act. So amendment of the Act is a long-drawn process. Interim measures also, if the High Court instructs that yes, the interim measures suggested by the primary applicant and also all the interveners as well as the entire committee, if the High Court agrees, then we will have a lot more stabilized situation regarding violence.
Thank you. And any other points, if they are. We are almost considered practically everything. It is more than 1 hour and 40 minutes. Dr. Chabra, thank you for joining us all the way from Delhi, and rest of the all our friends, please leave. I don't know Ujwala Vardapurkar's phone number and email. Then Snehal, Rajesh, and Anita. Yeah, please share it. I'm stopping the live streaming now. Arun, you also.